Hello friends, welcome to our Spark series. In our today's session, we are going to see about UDF. This is the continuation of our last video in which we saw about the Spark UDF. And in this video, we are going to see why to avoid a UDF in a Spark application. We will have a demo in both the languages, in Scala as well as in Python. And just a recap of our last session. In our last session, we had gone through how to create an UDF using Scala and Python, and we also understood how to register the UDF in Scala and Python while using a data frame API and while using a select statement, I mean like Spark SQL. We learned how to register a UDF, and again finally we learned how to use those UDF in our Spark application. These are all the three things that we learned in our last video. If you have missed that video, I will give it an I button. Please have a look into it before continuing with this video. Now let us move on to our today's session. Our today's session will be on why to avoid UDF in our Spark application. We will have a demo to understand this better. And for our demo, the use case that you are going to take is the same data frame that we saw yesterday. And in that data frame, we are going to apply a filter logic with the condition being created in a UDF. This is what the logic that we are going to try, and we are going to filter only for mail records. We will try on both the side, like we will use filter with condition directly and filter with UDF to understand this concept better. And by end of this session, we will come to know like why to avoid UDF. And let us start with PySpark first. I had opened a Jupyter notebook and created a Spark session and read the data frame as well. I have displayed the data frame here for us. Before moving on to the UDF, let us filter it with the condition first. I will apply a filter, and top of that I am giving a condition like gender column equal to mail dot show. So this works fine. I am assigning it to the another data frame. I am creating it as data frame 1. And now let us move on to our UDF creation part. Here I will name this UDF as fill_func_gen, and the input will be a string value. I am naming it as gender, and inside this we will have a return statement which will return true if it is equal to male. So this is our function. Like it will return true if gender is male, and it will false if the gender is female. We can check that once. And I'm giving it as mail. You can see here it is returning true. So our function works fine. Now let us register our function. For registering our function, we have to import the UDF package, which will be sql.functions. Inside that we are importing UDF, and also here, since it is a boolean type, we have to import the type as well. I am giving it a star. So now we imported all the packages. Let us register it first. For that I am doing fill func udf is equal to udf of fill function, which is of type, which whose return type is of boolean. So in this way we are . So in this way we have registered a UDF, and also since we are running a Spark SQL, we also have to register it using spark.sql.register. So I am using that as well, UDF.register, and I am giving just a fill rich, and I am giving the function. So now we have registered our function. Let us give df dot filter, and now inside this we are going to use and the column name is gender. Let me give show once. So our logic works fine. I will assign this to data frame called df2. Now we have created a data frame where df1 is created using a filter with condition, and df2 is created in a filter with UDF. Let us check the execution plan using explain command for df1 and for df2. Here we can see a difference in our filter itself. While scanning for the CSV file itself, we are having a predicate pushdown empty in df2, whereas in df1 it's scanning while reading the file itself, like whether the gender is male or female. So the advantage of using a catalyst optimization will not be taken when we are using a UDF, since catalyst optimization will not look into the code of UDF, and it will just simply move the code into a worker node for running the UDF. We can say like the UDF will be a black box for the catalyst optimizer to look into it. Let us quickly see on a Scala version as well. I had already opened a Spark shell in Anaconda command prompt and executed the commands that we need. I have read the data frame and gave show command here, and in the next one we are giving a filter condition directly without any UDFs, filter condition with data frame condition, and we are checking the output and writing it as another data frame named as df1. And now here we are creating a UDF in which we are checking whether the given column is male or not, and this again will return a boolean result, and we are applying a filter logic using a UDF that we created, and I have given a show command for us to test it, and I am assigning it now to df2. Finally, I am giving a explain for both the things. For df1, on the explain we can see we have a pushdown filter which is a catalyst optimizer's optimization, and for df2 when using a UDF we can see like there is no filter and it is directly being read. So this optimization, what happens is like if we are reading the filter and is it in a pushdown filter, then while reading a CSV file itself, it will filter for the data and bring in only the data that is required into a memory. But whereas here in this case, it will bring in all the data into the memory and then apply a UDF filter. So this is a difference. Again, in applying a UDF itself, you can see a difference between Scala and Python. Here you can see there is only one stage in which the file is being read and the filter is being applied. But whereas in Python function, you can see the file is being scanned, and then we have a batch eval process in our second stage only we are getting a filter operation. Why this is like our Spark itself, it is written in a Scala language. It supports JVM and Python. On the other hand, it needs serialization and deserialization, which has to be taken care. And because of this, it is taking some time and to convert the Python UDF into a Scala interpreted UDF. So this is for today, guys. Hope you understood the concept of UDF and why we need to avoid the UDF while developing a Spark application. Please try this on your own machine, and if you have any doubts, please let me know in your mail or in the comment box below. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up signal if you like my content. Thank you.